Hello, my name is Julie and this is KS Mom Crochets, and today is a Happy Mail video and also a little bit of a yarn unboxing. I did, you know, buy some yarn, guys, so I want to share it with you guys. But first I'm going to show you the Happy Mail that I got, and this was a gift from Sally over at Nanny Moon's Crochet, and I absolutely love watching Sally, so if you haven't seen her channel, I will have her channel linked below. Please go and check her out. She is such a sweet lady, and she makes the cutest amigurumi, and well, I mean, she makes more than just amigurumi. She makes all kinds of different projects, and yeah, it's just absolutely adorable things that she makes, and I highly recommend going and checking her out. So I did get some Happy Mail from her, and I never expect anybody to send me anything. Like, I don't know why everybody is so sweet and kind. Like, I never knew how many sweet and kind and thoughtful people that there are in this world until I started making YouTube, and I am thankful for everything that I have ever received. I hope that you all know that. But Sally had contacted me because she had seen that I had been getting some of the Crochet Now magazines, and she said that she had some physical copies that she would like to mail me. And, you know, how can I say no? I couldn't say no, but I have already opened her package, and she did include some candy, but unfortunately the candy's all gone, so I can't show you what she sent, but she did send some gummies that were Haribo, I think is how you say it, gummies in the shapes of eggs, and then there was some that was in the shapes of hearts, and then there were some, like, sweet tarts that said they were love hearts, and they were absolutely adorable, too, and yeah, it's all gone. All that candy got eat. So thank you so much, because my kids, my husband, myself, we all really enjoyed eating all that candy. So I will share the things that aren't the magazines, and then I'll share the magazines. But she did send some, like, little other things. But first off, well, I can't get it open. Here it is. Okay, I got it now. So she did send a card here, and it's absolutely beautiful. So I have to share her card. Oop, it's so, so pretty. Isn't that so pretty? I love that so much. So there is her beautiful card that she sent me, and she wrote such a sweet note. Such a sweet note in there as well. And then she also had sent a postcard. It says Snowdonia, I don't know if I said that right, North Wales. And the scenery there is just absolutely breathtaking. That is just such a beautiful postcard, and I will treasure this forever. I love that so much, Sally. And then she sent some sheets of stickers that have all different sayings on it. Love this life. This one says birthday stickers. And then this one is like, oh, hello, and little hearts, and focus, and love this. And then there's one that says a beautiful life. Making memories, take risks, just some cute little, like, stationery stickers. And then this one is all about summer, 4th of July barbecue, go on a vacation, just all kinds of different, stickers that I really, really love. And I will use these as well. And I will share some of these with my daughters too, and that they will like them, but I wanted to share those. I couldn't keep them from eating the candy, though, because they really, really dug into that candy as soon as they seen it. And then she also included this, so it's nice to have another one of these. I do have this already, but it is really nice to have another one of these, because I use stitch markers all the time, and I love that crochet hook. It is a 4.5 millimeter. I don't know if it's the same sized crochet hook or not. I can't remember that I have, but I do have one that looks like that. And then there was also this that came with a crochet hook too. It's got a 3 millimeter hook in it, and then it has this one of the hoops that I use to make doilies, which I thought was really, really thoughtful. And I love these mandalas with the, oh, what is that called? Is it like a tassel? I don't know. But I love that. Isn't that pretty? So I might try that, like to make something similar to this. I don't have the pattern for those, I don't think. But I do think that I could, you know, go from the picture and find a pattern that's similar. So that would be fun to do. I really like that. I have made with like dangled things with feathers and stuff before. Dream catchers for my daughters. So I have done that before. And then there was also some more stickers here. And I absolutely love these. They are a red dragon, which is, I guess the symbol is on the, I guess it's on the flag for Wales. And I think that this little badge here is the, or it's a pin, like a lapel pin. I think that is the, what the flag looks like. I'm not really positive, but I know that she did mention that in her video, recent video too, about the dragon. So I think it would be really cool to make a red dragon. So I might do that and then incorporate this pin somehow. So that would be fun to try to do that. So that's something I might try to do, because I really love making dragons. Okay, so that was all that was like extras, besides, like I said, the candy. And then she did send, there's 5 magazines, and this one actually is like a kit, I guess. It came with yarn and stuffing, and if there's crinkling, I'm sorry, it's just part of it. So it says everything you need to make your adorable Jade the Panda. So it's got a panda bear crochet kit. So this is the panda that you get the yarn to make, which is a lot of fun. So it's got your white and your black, and then there's some stuffing. And then looks like there's some other stuff in there too. I haven't opened this one. Okay, so looks like it has your safety eyes in there. There's some black felt. And then you have 2 skeins of yarn. Little sampler yarn here is a black and a white. And then you have your stuffing. And then there's also a wooden crochet hook there to use with that yarn. I can't tell what size yarn. I'm thinking that yarn is either, I'm thinking it's a three weight yarn. And then I think it's the pattern in here. Okay, no, the pattern is not. This is just a big sized picture of the panda bear that you can make, and there is where you would use that black felt, if you can tell. So that's really, really cute. I will use this and make that little panda bear, because I think that he is absolutely adorable. And I'm not going to try to put that back in there right now, because I don't want to have the crinkle. So here is the magazine, and this is a Love Crochet magazine. It is from September of 2019, and I am sure that you can, I'm thinking that this magazine is on Pocket Mags, the digital copy of it. But there is what, you know, some of the things that it has in it. And like I said, I really do want to make that panda bear. Now, I have looked through these already, and every single one of them had stuff that I wanted to make in it. When I will get around to making it all, I don't know. But I really do want to make a lot of things out of there. So, in this this side right here, I really love that bag right there with the granny squares. That is really cute. And then you have like a Halloween girl and a pumpkin. I really like that little girl right there. Look at that monster treat bag. That would be so cute for if you had like smaller children in your life that went trick-or-treating. I like these pencil holders, like the wraps for the jars. I have done that before. It's just been a really long time ago. And then on this side, it shows these little owls. They're so cute. I love those little owls. And then the little mice, Mr. and Mrs. Mouse. And then you have a, obviously another picture of the panda bear. Jade the panda bear. I was going to flip through and see if there was anything else. Oh, and look, there's a glasses case. That one is a drawstring, so like basically you just work up and then attach a drawstring. That's really cute. And there's also a little earbud. I made something like that before and put an applique on the front of it. There's some like dishcloths and stuff. These magazines are so much fun to look at. But like I said, I do think that I can find links to some of these. I don't know about this one in particular, but I will look. There's a granny square afghan in there. Little keychains. Here's some slippers. And then there's a scarf. It's just flipping through. Look at that little sweater. Ain't that cute? It's got ears for a fox on the hat. That is so cute. Okay, so here is this magazine. Like I said, it is the Love Crochet September of 2019. And I will try to find it if I can. I will try to look for it. For the digital copy if I can find it. And then I think there's another. Yeah. Here is another Love Crochet I was trying to see. This one just says November, but it doesn't say a year, and it says issue 12. Let me see if this one has an issue number on it. Okay, so this one is issue 78, the one with the panda bear. And then this one right here is another Love Crochet, and it is issue 12. And it has some really cute stuff in it, too. Like, those little penguins are so cute. Look at that little deer. You got a little cupcake, I think. Yeah, that's a cupcake. And then, let's just flip through it real quick. Like I said, this one was made in November. So, I'm thinking that it was earlier, obviously earlier than 2019. So here are some of the things in here. Like I said, there is a little penguins, some covers for like hangers, and then on this side there's some little cats. Those are cute. And then you have your cupcake, the deer. I've seen those before, made out of construction paper. Can't remember what that's called. Chains, a chain garland maybe. Little booties. This one right here is a Carrie Lord pattern. I do remember looking at that. And then looks like maybe a stocking. I'm not sure. Let's see. So I'll flip through this one real quick and see if anything. There's a closer up view of that cupcake. It looks very textured, which makes it look more three-dimensional. Usually they're just like straight up, so that's really cute. I think stuff like that makes really good pin cushions. some granny squares. Let's see. There's that little, a big picture of that penguin. That's super cute. I really like that a lot. And then here's the little, a big picture of the little deer. I love that they have, like, the big, huge pictures in the magazine. I don't think they make this magazine anymore, though. I think that this magazine has been discontinued. And then, Molly and Milo are the cat's names. Those are super cute. Super, super cute. And then here is the pattern that's in here by Carrie Lord. It's called Mr. Pickles. And it's a hedgehog. He's so cute. He is super adorable. I don't know if he's in Edward's Menagerie or not. Because this magazine may have came out around the time that book was released. Here's a little hat and scarf set for a little girl. She's adorable too. There's a lot of like articles in this about like to read, like about designers and things. That's interesting. Here's a pillow cushion. And I'm not sure. I'm thinking that that's fabric on one side and then crochet on the other. So that's kind of neat. I'm sure there's patterns like that, but I've never came across a pattern like that. So you take fabric and then your crocheted fabric and it looks like you sew it together. So that's definitely interesting. Or maybe they just sew it onto the pillow. I'm not sure. I don't know. That's cool. Here's a looks like a daisy hexagon blanket to me. That's really pretty. With all those different colors. A two-toned scarf. That's cool. Hopefully I'm showing these good enough. And then there's a bobble stitch bag. That would be very time consuming to make. It looks like it's lined too. Shows you how to line it. That's cool. How to line like the straps and everything. Oh, it's a here's a peppermint stocking. That's really cute. I think that's pretty much it for that one. And like I said, this is issue 12 of Love Crochet. So there's that one. So she sent me 3 of the Crochet Now magazines, and this one is issue number 48 of the Crochet Now magazine, and this is what it looks like. Now I know for sure that I can link the digital copies of these magazines if something strikes your fancy. Here are some of the patterns in this book. So you have some sweaters, a like vest, tank top, shirt, and then there's that little Santa Claus, which I think is absolutely adorable. I really like that wreath right there with the snowman. I've never made a wreath. I've always wanted to, and I have attempted like to make them before, but I've never like actually made a crocheted wreath. I have like made my own wreath, like decorating it with like ribbon and stuff, but I've never made a crocheted wreath. So that's something that I would love to do. And this sweater I think is really, really pretty. It almost looks like I don't know if that, it reminds me of the Drunken Granny stitch, but I can't really tell if that's exactly what that is. But I think that's really pretty. Now, I'm not big into garment making, but I don't know. I might make that one day. Who knows? I know my crochet evolves and changes over time. And here is a Wallace and Gromit pattern. It's called Feathers McGraw. He's super cute. I like him. He's cute. I never really watched Wallace and Gromit. But I know that there's a book out there right now that is very popular of the characters from that book or from that show. And there's another V-necked short sleeve shirt in here. There's a fringed clutch bag. I don't know about that one. I don't know if I would carry that, but that would be cute to, like, you know, make for Notions or something. Let's see. There's that tank top. Here is a tapestry crochet basket with reindeer. I guess that's a reindeer. Yeah, a rambling reindeer basket. That's really cute. There's a very beautiful shawl. That's really pretty. A Gatsby Glitz shawl. Here is that Santa Claus. I think he's so cute. Like, obviously I gravitate more toward the Amigurumi. They call him Father Christmas in here, not Santa Claus. But he is super cute. I really like him a lot. Like, it even shows you the back of him there. I really like him. I might make him at Christmas time. I'm trying to start making a list of, like, patterns that I want to do, because what happens is I always forget, like, I'll look through my magazines or things that I have, and I'll be like, oh, I really want to make that for Christmas, and then it's a long ways away from Christmas, so I forget. So I'm going to start writing projects down and, you know, not force myself to make them or anything, but just so I have a running list of things that I want to make. That way when Christmas time comes around, I can be like, oh, okay, I made that list, and I can look back and see if there's something that, you know, I want to make. There is a cute little penguin. He would be super fast to make. He's super cute. He's called Baby Penguin. Here's that snowman wreath, and I really like this a lot. It doesn't look intimidating. A lot of wreaths look intimidating to me, and that one looks like something that I could manage to do. So I think that's why I really like that one a lot. I love this pattern too. I remember it's called Grace the Swan. I think that's so pretty. I love that. I remember seeing that before when I looked through this. Thinking that might be, no, here's a bag, a Christmas present sack. It's got Christmas presents. I guess it's like corner to corner. Looks like it has a graph. And then there's like a stitch guide, and then that's it. Okay. So that was issue number 48. Okay, so the next one is issue number 53. And this is, like I said, the Crochet Now magazine too. And here are some of the projects on the front. Look at that little rabbit. He's super cute. I really like this right here, this cardigan. I really fell in love with that when I looked at this magazine. Let's see if I can find the page. Here's the page that has some of the projects in it. And then as I go through, I will show you the bigger pictures of some of these. And then there is the other side. So here is a really pretty scarf. It looks like, it reminds me of that Call the Midwife blanket with that stitch there in the middle. That's really, really pretty. I like that a lot. So there is a Rhapsody in Bloom scarf is what it's called. And then here's another hexagon blanket in different colors. Oh, I remember this pattern. I want to make this so bad. I want to make this so bad. And it is Mother Goose. Is she not adorable? Mother Goose and her little baby chicks, or little baby geese, or I don't know what the babies are called. Little baby ducks. Those are goslings. It says it right here. I love that so much with her little granny stitch shawl on. That is so cute. Like, this right here is one of the Beatrix Potter inspired patterns that I made, and it's one of my favorites. Like, I've had her, I think I made her in my beginning videos that I made, but I absolutely love her, so I know that if I make that, that I will absolutely love that too. Like, that's one of those patterns that will stay with me forever. But I absolutely love that. That's super, super cute. So that will be made one day by me for sure. There's articles and stuff, you know, about different people. And then here's that cardigan. It's called Darling Diamonds Cardigan. And that is so pretty. Like, I just absolutely love that. And I'm not really, like, a cardigan-wearing person. But I do love that. I love that there's, like, it almost looks like a diamond stitch there. So, you have, like, a solid stitch. And then it goes to the granny stitch. And then the granny stitch on the arms. That is really pretty. I really like that. Here's what the back of it looks like. So, it's not just a plain, simple granny stitch. So, I was really surprised because I normally don't. Like, I'll look at crocheted patterns for clothes and I'll be like, oh, that's really pretty. But it's not something that I would ever really think that I would want to make. But that is definitely something that I could see maybe one day in the future making. This little cushion is really cute. It's called Over the Rainbow Cushion. And that little baby is just adorable. They do a really good job of photography in this book as well. And then here is the Iris shawl. That's really pretty. And I guess that's the designer. I don't know if that's that one woman that does mosaic crochet or not. I'm not sure. It doesn't say her last name. Here is a jumping jelly bean throw. It uses super chunky yarn. It looks like it's just a V-stitch. To me? Yeah, I think that's the V-stitch. And then here's another wreath that I thought was really, really pretty. It would be very pretty for springtime right now. Very simple. Doable. It's doable. I love that. I think that's very pretty. And, you know, seeing wreaths like this too can, you know, inspire you to add other things to it too as well. But I like that. I think that's pretty. And then here is a slouchy granny stitch beanie. It's called the Spring Up Beanie. That's really cute. That is what it looks like. So it's like a slouchy hat. And then here is that little Easter bunny. He's super cute. Look at his little basket full of carrots. I love that. I like how he's got his little hips. So there is the back side of him. Here is another shawl, and it is mosaic crochet. That's really pretty. That would be very thick, I bet. Let's see. Oh, and this book, I have looked at, that's something that I really like about Crochet Now, is that I've noticed that when there's books, they give you like a pattern. Sometimes they'll give you like one of the patterns from new and upcoming books or like recent releases. And this book must have released around the time that this issue came out. And is that cute amigurumi animals right there. And they actually have one of the patterns. Like, there's some of the patterns that are in the book. And I'm pretty sure that Caroline from For the Love of Crochet, I'm pretty sure she made something out of this book. But I could be wrong. But I've been thinking about buying this book for a while. Just haven't. But it does have one of the patterns, which I thought was really, really cool. It's Mimi the Mouse. So she's super cute. And then there is another picture of her. So Well, that's really cute. I really like how that they do that in these magazines. And then this is a beautiful blanket. I wish that I loved to do squares. I do like to make squares. I just don't like to put them together. But this blanket is so pretty. It's called Hearts and Flowers. And that is just, oh, I just love that so much. It's so pretty and like elegant looking. I just love it. And then here's an egg topper by Carrie Lord, which I thought was kind of weird. But maybe that's a thing in the UK. I don't know. Do you all top your eggs in the UK? I'm not sure. But it's like for a boiled egg, I guess. But it's just a little bird head. A hen egg. Hen egg topper. And then here is another, or a cushion. It's a terrific tapestry cushion. So it's got some tapestry crochet patterns. And then here is a bouquet shawl. That's really pretty too. And then here's just a simple peaches and cream. It's called Peaches and Cream Baby Blanket. And I'm not sure what stitch it uses, but it's really pretty. A spring daisy cushion. That's cute. I don't like sewing little tiny squares together, though. So, like, if I see patterns like that, I will make the squares a little bit bigger. I like the way that they put the buttons at the top like that, though. That's really cool. That way you can, you know, take your pillowcase off and wash it. And then I think that's it for this one. So, that was a really good magazine as well. Like, every single one that she sent me, like, I would make something out of every one of them. So, like I said, this one was, issue 53. Okay, so the last one that she sent me was issue number 90 of the Crochet Now magazine. And this is what the front of it looks like. And somebody needs to tell me what this is, because evidently this is really popular, and I've never heard of Bagpuss. I don't know what that is, but I've seen that in a lot of the Crochet Now magazines, and I'm not sure what it is, so y'all let me know. Is it like a cartoon, or is it like, I don't know, is it a cartoon, like a plush that you can buy? I don't know, but there are some of the patterns and that's going to be in this magazine. That little love bug is just so adorable. But I don't know what that one is. Maybe it'll tell me and I just didn't see it. So here is a basket weave hat and scarf. And I just think that's cute. I would never wear two pom-poms on each side of my head like that, but I could totally see making that for a kid or a teenager. I think teenagers would wear that. That would be really cute. But I love the look of the basket weave stitch. It's just very time consuming to do. And then here's that little love bug. It's called Lola the Love Bug, and she is super cute. Look how cute that is. I don't know if it shows the back of her. Yeah, it does. And then here's what the back of her looks like. That is so cute. I love that so much. And then here is the Bagpuss cushion. It's Britain's favorite old cloth cat. I don't know. Is it a cartoon? Is it just like a plush that you can buy? But there is the cushion. And then here's a picture of like a stuffed animal, I guess. So is it based off of a stuffed animal? But evidently that's really popular. So if anybody is from the UK, you let me know what that is. But it's cute. It's really cute. I have a black and white little wind-up. He doesn't talk anymore, but he used to. That is black and white cat that I have. That reminds me of that. But it's not obviously the same thing. But that was a pillow of that cat. And then here is a shawlette and mitts. a little shawlette bobbling around blanket. So it's a blanket and it's got like different bobble stitches and like a wave stitch there of color. It's really pretty. A little cable, a cable bag for storing your crochet supplies for cold winter days is what it says. So that's, I like the cabled look on the front, which is why it's called a cable bag, I guess. And I love how all of these have articles with Carrie Lord in it. So, you know, that's always fun for me. And then this is a little, it's called Spike Tea Pin Cushion. And it's so cute. It's a little cactus in a teacup. Spiked tea. That's so funny. But it's, you know, a pin cushion. That is adorable. And then here's like a little collar that you would wear around your shirt. And then I love this little bear. Osito the bear. I think he's so cute. I love him. And I love his little stubby legs. He reminds me of that little fox's little stubby legs that I'm making right now. I just think that's super cute. And then that's what the back of him looks like. Here is a hibernate blanket. Looks like it's a cabled blanket, maybe. I think it has cable stitches. It's kind of hard to see. And then a, maybe she did this one because there's like a little, like, I don't know. Maybe she was adding up how much yarn she needed. Did you do this pattern? But it is called Astrid Jumper. And it's a little, like, sweater. And I love that. I have some, older, like, vintage, doll dress patterns. And there's, like, notes in it. And it's so much fun to see people's handwriting and stuff. Because I'm always like, I wonder if they did that or... You know, what were they thinking? Who were they making that for, you know? It just gets you thinking. Like, I just love that so much. And then, here's a hot water bottle cozy for your hot water bottle. It's got bobble stitches on it. And then some little, face scrubbies from Bella Coco. Some little circle face scrubbies. Here is a lavender cushion. That's cute. It's like something so simple, yet they took that little bouquet and added it to the front. That's really cute. And it's got like the, I guess it's like a bobble stitch around the sides of it. So that's cool. And then here is a... part of a crochet along. This is you only get one of the squares. So evidently in this year of Crochet Now magazine, they had in each magazine so many squares that went with that blanket, and then that is the square that you get for this issue. And then there's another one, I think, right here, square for that blanket. And then here are some more, like, cozies or, jar cozies or jar covers. And it's called, Side Saddle. Kind of looks like the Drunken Granny stitch to me as well. I really like that a lot. I bet that would work up super cute. And then, obviously, they have one with, like, flowers, one with pins. You know, you could use one for, you know, your crochet hooks. Here is a bobble stitch love. It's called Bobbling Love Cushion. So it's a bobble stitch heart pillow. That's pretty cool. I like that. They use chunky yarn on that. And it has like a chart that you follow. And then the back of it is like striped. And then here is another... like cabled looking blanket that looks very difficult to me. It's called the Calm Sea Throw, but it is so pretty. And then here's like an up close. I was trying to get it to show up close picture of the stitch. I don't know how well I'm doing showing you all this. And then they always like have like different yarns and stuff. They show you different yarns. That's so pretty. Oh my goodness. Look at that colorway. I don't know if they make those anymore, but that is so pretty. And then here's a little cowl for a child. Look how cute. I love that. I love it when they put pictures of kids. And then these are so cute. Oh my gosh, they're so cute. Dapper Duck and Fabulous Frog. Those are so adorable. Like, I don't know, that frog, I just love him so much. He's got his little vest on. He's adorable. I love that. And then I think that might be it. Yes. So that is all of the magazines that came from Sally. And I just want to say thank you so much, Sally, like from the bottom of my heart. You just don't even know how happy that that your package made me. Like, I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. And I thank you so much for just being so generous and just such a sweet and lovely person. And like I said, if you haven't heard of Nanny Moon's Crochet, I will have her channel linked below. So please go over and check her out. Now, I know this video is kind of long, but I do have a small yarn haul from Mary Maxim. But I'm sure this video, I can edit it down a little bit. But I got only one yarn and I got all different colors in it. And I said I wasn't going to buy any more yarn, but, you know, there's always that but, that kicker, you know? And it was the fact that I had a coupon for Mary Maxim where that I have bought from them before. They have, like, a points rewards points thing. And I had points from my birthday. And then, I don't know, there's other ways that you can get points besides just ordering things from them as well. And so, I had a discount. And they were doing free shipping over $35, which may or may not still be going on. I'm not sure. But that was for the U.S. But I literally spent $35 is what I spent. And I paid $1.62 for most of this yarn. Some of it was only $1.63. But I really like the yarn a lot, and so I wanted to get some. And it is all the Bon Bon Eintz yarn. It is a DK weight. I have no idea what half of these colors are, but I think I can tell you by, because the sheet has the number on it. The label only has the number. And I think I can look at the sheet and tell you the actual color names of it. But this is a 100% acrylic yarn. It is 100 grams or 300 meters. So it's a little over 300 yards, I guess. I don't know. I know yardage is more than meters. And like I said, it is a DK weight yarn. And it's super soft. Like, I really like it a lot. And after I have worked with it a couple times, because last time I ordered for Mary Maxim, I got 3 skeins of this just to try it. And then I kind of fell in love with it. So I think it's a clearance out yarn. So that is why I thought, well, I'll probably never be able to get this yarn again. And I have a coupon for it. And they have... you don't see it unless you go onto the actual listing for the yarn. But if you buy 4 or more skeins of this, it's only $1.99 a skein. And then, like I said, I had a discount and free shipping. So, I mean, it was like win-win-win. I couldn't resist. So, into my cart it went. But this color right here, 684... is called Merlot, and it's like a purpley color. And some of the colors look a little bit different in person than they do on the website, but they are all very, very pretty. And I don't think I got every single color, because there was a few colors that I wanted like 2 of, So I didn't get every single color because I already had maybe those colors in another DK weight that I can mix with this. But I noticed when I was making my little fox that my sport weight and this wasn't mixing really well. So I wanted, you know, I just wanted it. So I got it. And then here is this really pretty color. And this is, let me see if I can find it. I can't remember which number. 6, 7, 5. Berry. The color berry. And it's so pretty. It's like a pinky, magenta color, I guess. I really like that color a lot. I'm like, here it is up next to that purple. And I did want to say that this did have a spot. This was the only skein that had a spot on it. And Mary Maxim's customer service was amazing. So if you order from them and you have an issue with your yarn, whether it's, you know, because things happen, I mean, they may not inspect every single skein of yarn to make sure that it's perfect. But they are great about their customer service. Like, they literally got back with me within 24 hours of emailing them about this. And they are sending me a replacement for whatever this is on this skein. So, and it's not even the whole skein that's damaged. It's just, like, that much of it. But, you know, that's quite a bit once you unroll it. But they are going to replace this. So I did want to let you know about Mary Maxim's customer service. I've been a customer there for years. And this is the first time that I have ever had to contact customer service, honestly. And I've had them contact me before over something with my order. But I have never actually reached out. I had to reach out and contact them. And then here is another color. This is like a red, burgundy looking color. 220. And it is called wine. So it's wine color. But it's like a deep red. I love that color so much. It's so pretty. That's one of my favorite colors. And then here is a pink 418. Which is called Soft Rose. And they did have another pink on their website. So they had two different pinks, and this was the lighter of the pinks, I'm pretty sure. But like I said, this one is called Soft Rose. And I should have wrote the names down on these labels, which I plan on doing. I just haven't done it yet. And this one is just called Red, and it's very bright. And just for reference, here's the wine with the red. So this one is a pretty, I mean, it's not as bright as it's showing on camera, about like that, but it's very pretty red. Okay. Oh, and another thing is I got this yarn within like 2 days. Like, they shipped it out the same day. Like, I ordered it really early, like a.m., like, I don't know, 5 o'clock in the morning or something, and they shipped it out that same day. So, that was cool. 326. This one is called Light Sage, so it's like a really pale green. I'm thinking this is one of them that might have looked a little bit different on their website, but it's still very pretty, and I'm happy with it. So this is the Light Sage. And then this one is called Straw, and I have bought this color again, but I think that this would be perfect for a kangaroo. So that's why I got two of them. So I have like 2.5, I think, or a little over, almost 3 skeins of this left. So this one is called Straw. I'm running out of room here. And then this one is called Rust, which I am using on that fox. And I just really like this color, and it's perfect for fall things. So I bought two of these as well. And then I'm pretty sure this one is just called Black. Yep, this one's just Black. And then this one is just called White. So I got Black and White. And then here is a beautiful teal color. Let's see what color it is. 400. And it is called Aqua. That is just so pretty. And some of the labels look different than others. I'm not sure if it was this one. I will try to show you the difference. But some of my labels did look a little bit different. But I don't mind about that either. This one, like I said, is called Aqua. And then this one. It's called Pine. So it's like a really deep green. And I love that color. And I regret not getting more than one of these. Because I really like that color a lot. I just love that. Okay. So that is half of it. And then I have another basket. I've already put this yarn away. I wanted to share it with you all. Here's what the difference in the labels looks like. Like, some of them will have this label. And then some of them have this label. So, I don't know why, but some of them did. And then, 263. This one is called Lagoon. So, it's like a blue color. Right here. And then this one is called Denim. So, it's like a blue jeans color, I guess. There's the two together. Those are really pretty. And then here's the three blues together. So, let's see. Denim, Lagoon, and Aqua. And I feel like they had a really pale blue, but I didn't get that one because I already had some of it. And then the rest of these are just browns. This color is called Caramel. Or caramel, however you want to say it. It's very pretty. Can't ever have enough neutrals if you like making bears or, I don't know, bunnies, all kinds of stuff. Uses brown. So I always get two of, like, the neutral colors. The only thing I was disappointed about is that they didn't have any gray in this yarn. But that's okay because I do have some gray DK yarn already. This one is called Chocolate. And I did get two of those as well. Like I said, perfect bear colors. And then this one looks a little bit different in person than it did on their website, but it's still very pretty. And it is called Brown Heather. So it almost has like a lighter strand running through it. I really like it. So I did get two of those as well. So here are the three browns together. And you can see a little bit more how that yarn, how that heather, the brown heather, has that, like, lighter color running through it. So that is all the yarn that I got from Mary Maxim. And like I said, I thought that was a great deal and I couldn't pass it up because I really am enjoying using, like, DK and sport weight yarns for my amigurumis. So it will definitely get used. And I had cleared out some space for it too, so I made sure that I had somewhere to put it before I bought it. But anyway, that is all that I have for you all. This is a really long video, but like I said, I am on vacation, so you may see me again sooner rather than later. I'm not sure. It depends on what my kids get me into, because they just want me to run all over the place. You know how that goes. So we'll see how that it goes. And in case I forgot to say it last time, I hope that you all had a wonderful Easter weekend. And thank you so much for hanging out with me. And until next time, guys, I will see you in another video. Bye.